Splashing News! This time, we're covering water-related news for the month of July. The focus this month was on water disruptions in Sabah, which was caused by the earthquake in June. It was found that debris at the water intake point, which supplied water to several areas, was deeper than anticipated. The water supply was said to be in danger, even in the future, because of the source of water, such as vegetation and water catchment, have been destroyed. A geologist professor from UMS also mentioned that mudslides and flash floods would prevail as the rocks, soil, boulders and vegetation are now loosened. River water has become so polluted that even water treatment plants have closed down, and water tankers were reduced to distribute clean water in its place. This problem continued to persist, and in some areas, it even lasted the whole month. The problems have led to the Sabah government officials considering several new alternatives for clean water supply. One of it is rainwater harvesting. The other one is harvesting water directly from the waterfalls, you know, before it reaches the muddy, polluted rivers. Then, there is also the good news that many have been waiting for. Yes, the water restructuring deal has been finalized. Ministry of Energy, Green Technology and Water said that the benefits to the people in the Klang Valley is expected to be great because the overall water supply services can now be improved. International news this time is rather interesting. Apparently, there's this amoeba that eats people's brains, and it can be transmitted through water. It can kill people, and it has actually entered the water supply system in Louisiana. This amoeba can only kill people by entering the nose of a person, so drinking the water is fine. Therefore, one can only be affected if they swim or wash their faces in the water and the water enters their nose. The supply is undergoing a 60-day chlorination burn to make sure that the amoeba is killed. That is not the only scary story about water supply, however. In a town called Old River Winfrey, we have another kind of pest in the water supply. This time, it's worms. Yes, small red worms wriggling around that you can actually see with our naked eyes. Residents have seen it coming up of their taps, sprinklers, and even shower heads. Reports mention that some of them are still alive and moving. The cause for this incident is unknown, and the water services there are still trying to find out what really happened. It is clear how water problems can be caused by both human and non-human factors. Mother Nature does not care if we are celebrating festivals or not. Natural disasters can come at any time. On the other hand, water services provider too can make mistakes at times. They may overlook dangerous contents in the water. Authorities have a huge role to play in providing basic services to the people, especially during the festive season, where people need it the most. Consumers, on the other hand, will need to constantly check the quality of services they receive, at least for their own safety. By supporting and giving feedback to each other, our water industry will be able to reach high quality someday. That's all for today. Bye-bye.